Hello and welcome to Thorlabs. This video explains how to find and optimize the transient absorption signal after the setup has been pre-aligned. To perform this optimization, only the final mirror in the pump beam path, labeled mirror PU2 in the kit, will be adjusted. First, for both the pump and probe lasers, turn the power key switch to the on position and open the laser shutter. Wait about 30 seconds for the indicator lights on each laser to stop blinking. Next, open the software for this educational kit. Check the box for reduced pump frequency and then activate the laser. A green circle should appear next to the laser status and the status should read on. Now, turn on the photodiode. The power status LED on the side of the housing should appear green. Note that the photodiode gain setting should already be set to 10 decibels. To help view the beam positions, place the VRC2 visible detector card in the card slot of the sample holder. Then, use the mirror mount adjustment knobs to overlap the green pump laser beam with the probe laser beam. The top right adjuster translates the vertical beam position. Adjust this knob until the two beams are vertically aligned. The bottom left adjuster changes the horizontal position. Adjust this knob until the two beams overlap. Now it's time to put the sample in the beam path. First, close both laser shutters and remove the detector card from the sample holder. Then, place the cuvette into the slot of the sample holder that sits in the beam path. Rotate the locking screw to secure the cuvette into place. Open the laser shutters. In the software, deactivate the reduced pump frequency setting. Set the peak finder threshold slightly below the maximum peak value and set the pump probe delay to 200 nanoseconds. Using the transient signal live feed graph for guidance, adjust one knob on the mirror to see how the signal responds. This is the red trace in the lower graph. After one axis is maximized, adjust the second one. If the signal is no longer visible at this point, replace the sample with the detector card and repeat this procedure. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to contact Thorlabs tech support at the details on the screen.